This video shows how to configure a Databricks cluster to run Python transformations. In part two of this series, we'll show you how to run the Python transformation. By running the Python transformation on a Databricks cluster, we can leverage the Python transformation's machine learning capabilities, as well as the Azure Databricks analytics platform. To create an Azure Databricks cluster, let's open the Azure Databricks workspace and create a new cluster. First, give the cluster a name. For the Databricks runtime, we'll select 5.5 LTS. For Python version, let's keep the default version 3. Then configure the cluster according to your needs. Next, we'll need to configure the access key to use for cluster storage. Under the Advanced Options, open the Spark tab. Then paste your code. Then we need to map the location of our init script on the Databricks file system. Go to the Init Scripts tab. Here's the init script that we want to use. During cluster creation, the init script will install NumPy and scikit-learn so we can use these third-party libraries in the Python transformation. To make this script available to the Databricks cluster, we'll use Postman to upload the init script file onto the DBFS. In Postman, let's create a new post request using Databricks Put API. Under Authorization, choose Bearer Token. Now we need to generate a new access token in Azure. Then we can copy and paste the token into Postman. We'll use this token again later when we create the Databricks connection in the Administrator tool. Under Body, select Form Data, and then select the path, contents, and override attributes. Enter the path on the DBFS where we want to upload the init script. Ensure the path name includes the name of the init script file. Next, for contents, add the F flag so we can upload a file. To do so, click the File option, navigate to the local directory containing the file, and select the file to upload. Finally, set the override attribute to true. To test the upload, click Send. The upload is successful if we get a 200 status code. Since the init script has been uploaded onto the DBFS, copy the path and paste it onto the init scripts tab of our new Databricks cluster. Now we can create the cluster. While the cluster is being created, we can go to the Administrator tool and create a new Databricks cluster configuration. In the Administrator tool, click Connections, Cluster Configurations, New, and then Cluster Configuration. We'll call this configuration Databricks CCO. Select Databricks as the distribution and import the configuration from the cluster. For the Databricks domain, we can copy the workspace name from the Databricks URL. For the token ID, we can use the token that we created while we upload the init script. To find the Databricks cluster ID, go to the cluster that we created, expand Advanced Options, go to the Tags tab, and copy the cluster ID. Next, select Create Connection to create a Databricks connection after importing the cluster configuration. To complete the configuration, click Next and then Finish. To configure the Databricks connection for the Python transformation, navigate to the Databricks connection and edit Advanced Properties. Here, we can add the properties that the Python transformation needs. Add the first property, which defines the location of the Python executable. Then add the second property, which defines the location of the Python installation directory. Let's see if the cluster is running by switching to the Azure Databricks workspace and going to the event log for the cluster. Here, we can see that the cluster has been created and the init script ran successfully. In this video, we showed you how to install third-party Python libraries on an Azure Databricks cluster, how to integrate the Azure Databricks cluster with the Informatica domain. In part two, we will show you how to run the Python transformation on the cluster. For more information, see the Azure Databricks guides on our documentation portal, visit our community and support hubs, or check out our website.